Happy Thursday, everyone! Yes, at tatlong araw na lang, bagong taon na! Wow. Grabe! Pero for sure, marami rin ang mga pahabol na Christmas party and reunions dyan. Habol naman rin tayo, B-Fam. Okay, kasama niyo pa rin ako, your main girl, Shania Gomez, as we continue to celebrate the spirit of Christmas.
Yes, and you're also here with me and VJ Sam with 2Ms. Of course, aside from being with our loved ones, listening to music can also be the perfect way to keep your holiday spirits up. At saan pa ba ang perfect place to jam but here in your favorite global hangout in collaboration with the number one music channel in the Philippines and the beat of our culture,
BRGY X-Mix! Ang saya!
I know, I can't believe it's already Christmas.
No, because so it's done!
No, I mean like the Christmas season, yeah. Holiday season. It's yeah. So fast, no?
Super fast. Super,
and we all know that nobody does Christmas like Filipinos do.
Amen!
Christmas. Yes, because you all know Filipino Christmas has always been a very unique experience for all of us. Syempre, hindi mawawala ang masarap na food, fun and witty gifts, yeah. Out of this world games. At syempre, ang kantahan.
Totoo!
Is it even a reunion if there's no karaoke? Say. As in, bigay na bigay, diba? Pag holiday yes. Season. Like from family presentations to simply singing karaoke songs, music will never be forgotten in Filipino Christmas celebrations. And syempre, kasama rin dyan ang iconic ABS-CBN Christmas Station IDs. I remember when I was younger. Younger? I'm still
woo!
Younger. So when I was younger, I would always look forward to, actually until now, I always look forward to the ABS-CBN Christmas Station ID. But I'm sure everybody has their own favorite Kapamilya Christmas Station ID. So kayo ba guys, ano ba yung favorite ninyo? Or pwede rin, what's your favorite OPM song to sing during Christmas parties and reunions? So whatever your answer may be, our guest for today is most likely the man behind your favorite OPM songs. Because from joining the Himig Handog competition back in 2001, he is now the most streamed Filipino songwriter and producer on Spotify. With nearly 500 compositions under his name, he is also ABS-CBN Music's creative director. So everybody, let's welcome Mr. Music himself, Sir Jonathan Manalo!
Hello, Sir John! How are you today?
I'm good.
But first of all, I want to go right into it because there's so much to talk about with you. You have so many accomplishments. First of all, congratulations! You just earned 22 nominations in this year's Awit Awards. What was your reaction after first hearing this amazing news?
Every time it happens, parang laging it's happening for the first time. Yung feelings is the same. And yun lang, sobrang gratitude lang kasi wala na ibang feelings kundi overflow of gratitude in my heart.
Like we said in our intro, you started off in 2001, you know, before being known as Mr. Music. Listeners and singers, you started in the industry through a contest, which until now has made, and you know, like a lot of artists came out of also. Mm-hmm. So that is Himig Handog.
Himig Handog.
Yes!
Yung theme that year was para sa mga kabataan. Ako, first timer, mm-hmm. and then siguro dahil nga ang contest is kabataan theme. Mm-hmm. It's Himig Handog sa mga bagong kabataan. So kahit na ako yung bago, that's my advantage. Mm. And I trumped them all.
No, but of course, then going on from there, I mean, that opportunity opened up so many doors for you, especially when it comes to producing music and for ABS-CBN Teleserye shows and even reality shows like shout out, PBB, Pinoy Big Brother. Yeah. I mean, you just kept making hits, one hit after another, and you've worked with some of the biggest names in the industry. I mean, you yourself are a big name, but you've worked with so many other big names mm-hmm. in the industry. So, I mean, let's talk about your career journey naman. Let's take a trip down memory lane. Yes. So, we have a game to play with you. Kasi we like to keep it light and fun dito sa BRGY. But we'll show you three images of musicians that you've worked with. Mm. And in these different, there are different milestones in your career, these artists. And you just have to choose a song from this songbook that we'll give you. And the song that you choose will be a message that you want to give to that artist.
Mm. Oh,
okay. G.
Go.
So are you ready for the first photo?
Ready.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Ay,
Eric. Kuya Eric.
Naku, wala dyan eh.
Okay, go. Which one would you like?
It's Hanggang sa Huli.
Oh!
Kasi Hanggang sa Huli is yung good latest choice. Single niya.
Yes, yes.
Actually, part yun nung last anniversary album that I did. Pero sobrang, hindi pinalano, pero nag-timing na, ayun yung song na naging theme song niya for his mom and his dad when they passed away. Kasi yan yung last song na pinarinig niya sa mama niya when before she passed away.
We know naman na you've had a very long friendship and working relationship with Eric. Because after Kuya Eric won Star in a Million, you were working on him, working with him on his first album. Yes. So what were some of the more memorable songs you wrote or produced?
Yung first single ni Eric will always be memorable. Yung Pagbigyang Muli. Kasi karaoke staple. Naging karaoke staple.
Yes, yes.
Tawag ng tanghalan. Ano nga, parang sabi ko, ang daming times na yun ang kinakanta, tapos si Eric yung nagja-judge.
Oh my God, nalang mo.
Second photo.
Okay, next.
Ay, Angeline.
Yes.
Aww.
It's her first single. And I specifically wrote that song for her sa grand finals ng Star Power, where she won It's Patuloy Ang Pangarap. Sobrang totoo din sa life niya. Kasi, yes, ang dami ng mga natupad na pangarap sa life niya. Pero, patuloy lang ang pangarap. Yeah. Di ba?
Just like we, Eric, you're also there with Ate Angeline's whole journey naman. Yeah. Di ba? Sabi mo nga, you wrote sa Patuloy Ang Pangarap. Mm-hmm. So, about writing the song about dreams and how does it feel to see her now?
Sobra lang akong happy sa nangyari sa kanya. Kasi yung story din ni Angeline, rugs to riches din siya, di ba? And sobra talagang yung naging successful yung career niya.
Okay.
Okay, last but not least. Very not least at all.
Yes.
We have...
Grabe
naman. So, yun nga, yung Ililigtas Kanya is a song that I was able to write for him nung time na nagkaroon siya ng health scare and sobrang serious noon. And naging timing lang din na ang Dreamscape, sina Sir Deo, si Coco, is looking for a new song sa bagong season ng Ang Provinciano.
Yes.
So sabi, actually lumapit sila kay Sir Gary. Galing lang nun sa, magaling na si Sir Gary and it's a miracle. So dumalaw sina Coco, sina Sir Deo, sabi nila Sir Gary, pwede bang gumawa ka ng song na about your journey? Na tungkol sa miracle.
Kasi for you, saying that it's such ang alayo ng pangarap before to be able to work with him and then now being able to work with him so closely, like, parang for me and for all of our viewers watching, parang, okay, that means that maybe my dreams aren't so far-fetched after all. Yeah, baka kaya pala yung mga dreams
That's
ko.
That's so true.
So, ayun. So, I mean, Sir Jonathan told us how heartfelt stories can reach and change people. His hit songs that can be heard all over the airwaves are proof of that. Pero balita namin, a show was made to pay tribute to his music legacy. After the break, we'll see how he gave his songs a new life. BRGY will be right back.
Tangi kong hiling, di susuko kakating.